In this screencast, we're going to work on a fairly complex material balance problem that involves multiple units and a recycle stream. Now, it's going to focus on the idea of a solution and what happens when you have a slurry, you know, a mixture of solids and solution together. So, let me read the problem statement. As I'm reading this, try to kind of sketch out a picture, and then I'll set up our diagram and we'll work through these material balances to solve this problem. So, we have a salt, potassium dichromate. It's to be recovered from a 25% weight aqueous solution. Now the solution is joined by a recycle stream and fed to a crystallizer centrifuge where enough water is removed so the outgoing solution is 85% weight water. Exiting the crystallizer are the crystals with 10% of the solution, so that's our slurry, and the remaining solution which forms the recycle stream. Now the filter cake contains 85% crystals and the rest solution. This filter cake is fed to a dryer where it's contacted with dry air. This causes the remaining water to be evaporated, thus leaving pure potassium dichromate crystals. So we're given some information. The air leaves the dryer with a 0.08 mole fraction, that's water, and we're trying to produce 1,000 kilograms an hour of potassium dichromate. So given our basis of 1,000 kilograms an hour potassium dichromate crystals exiting the dryer, we want to determine, one, the water evaporated in the crystallizer centrifuge, two, the mass flow rate of the recycle stream, and lastly, the moles of air that flow through the dryer. So let me take this information and start sketching out our picture. So first we know we have a feed that enters our crystallizer centrifuge combination. There's a mixture that leaves the crystallizer centrifuge that enters a dryer. Then leaving this dryer is our final product. So we know this is 1,000 kilograms per hour of our potassium dichromate, which I'll call KD. So there's a couple other streams we need to fill in. One, we have a recycle stream. So we know that there's a stream that comes out of the centrifuge in crystallizer that is the solution that's fed back into the main feed line to the crystallizer and centrifuge. So we have a recycle stream there. We also know that water is being evaporated, which causes the crystals to precipitate out and get our solids. So we have a water line. And then into the dryer, we have air that's removing the water from the crystals, and so we'll have a stream coming out of the dryer that's both air and water. So now I need to label all of our streams with known information from the problem statement as well as our unknown variables. And I'll do this in a slightly neater fashion. So we're told our main feed line is 25% weight potassium dichromate. We're told that out of the centrifuge in crystallizer we get a solution that is 15% weight potassium dichromate, the rest water. We're also told that that filter cake that enters the dryer is 85% weight solids. So that means 85% weight of this stream going to the dryer is our solid crystals. The other 15% weight is our solution, which is saturated with potassium dichromate. So we have potassium dichromate that hasn't come out of solution yet. Now we're told that our basis is 1,000 kilograms of solids per hour. We have a mole fraction of water in our exit stream from the dryer as 0.08. We know that the recycle stream is going to have the same composition as the solution that's leaving the crystallizer and centrifuge. The only other information that we don't have marked on our chart is that this stream is 90% of the solution. So 10% of the solution goes with the filter cake. The other 90% is our recycle stream. So now, I'm going to label all our unknowns. We don't know the mass flow rate of our feed. We don't know the mass flow rate of our recycle stream, which is something we're looking for. Thus, we don't know the mass flow rate or the composition entering our crystallizer and centrifuge. We're looking for the amount of water that is being evaporated from our crystallizer and centrifuge. We don't know the mass flow rate that's entering our dryer, nor do we know the molar flow rates of air into the dryer, which we're looking for, or the total molar flow rate out. So the three pieces of information that we need to find to solve this problem are the mass flow rate of our recycle stream, the mass flow rate of water that we're evaporating off, and the molar flow rate of air that passes through the dryer. So where do we start? Typically, the best place to start is by doing a degree of freedom analysis, and I'll start by doing a degree of freedom analysis on the overall process. Now, by doing this, we have the following unknowns. Mass flow rate of our feed, M1, the exit flow rate of our water from the crystallizer and centrifuge, the molar flow rate of air into the dryer, and the molar flow rate of the exit from the dryer. Now, the composition of the air in is just pure air, and the composition of M3 is just pure water. So we have four unknowns. In terms of relationships that we know, we could write three material balances, since we have three different species, potassium dichromate, water, and air. Now, this gives us a degree of freedom of 1, which means that we can't solve for these unknowns. However, under more careful examination, we could see that N1 and N2 are just water and air, and M3 is just water. So we have one stream that has our potassium dichromate. So we could do a potassium dichromate balance to solve for M1. So let's do that. We know that 25 weight percent of our entering feed stream, M1, must be equal to our production rate. This means that M1 is 4,000 kilograms per hour. So unfortunately, now that we've removed one of the unknowns, that doesn't mean we could write three species balances for the other three unknowns. Because as we stated, N1, N2, and M3 only have water and air. So we can't do a balance for the potassium dichromate. So we need to move elsewhere to solve. Now, using that same logic as before, we could do a balance around the dryer, since only one stream in and one stream out has the potassium dichromate. So let's take a look at the dryer and do a potassium dichromate balance around the dryer. So we know that 85 weight percent of stream 4 that enters the dryer is our potassium dichromate solids. However, we still have potassium dichromate in the solution. So 15 weight percent of that solution, which is 15 weight percent of the main mass flow rate, is our potassium dichromate. Now, these two values have to be equal to all the potassium dichromate coming out of the system, which is 1,000 kilograms per hour. So now we could solve for M4. When I solve for M4, I get 1,146 kilograms per hour. So at this point, we could go through a degree of freedom analysis on the mixing point, on the crystallizer centrifuge, again on the dryer, the overall balance. Sometimes it's nice to just step back, take a look at each of these units, and figure out maybe what we're missing. And if we look at the crystallizer and centrifuge, the only variable that we don't know is M3. And what I mean by that is we could take out this recycle stream and do it around this area, and we know what's coming into that system, we know what's leaving. So the only variable of unknown is the water being evaporated, which is something we're looking for. So we don't even have to worry about M2 or M5. So let's do an overall balance around the crystallizer centrifuge recycle stream area and solve for M3. So we have 4,000 kilograms per hour coming into this area. This has to be equal to what leaves, which is 1,146 kilograms per hour plus M3. So now we can solve for M3, and we get 2,854. So we've solved one part of the original problem statement, how much water is being evaporated from the crystallizer and centrifuge. So we still need to figure out M5, the mass flow rate of our recycle stream, as well as N1, the molar flow rate of our air coming into the dryer. So let's take a look at our recycle stream. Recall that in the problem statement, we're told that 90% of the solution is recycled. Well, we have an idea of part of what isn't recycled, and we know the mass flow rate associated with that, so we should be able to figure out the amount of solution that's recycled. So let's set this up. So 15 weight percent of our M4 stream, which we solved for, is 1,146 kilograms per hour. Now that's equal to 10% of the total solution. So one way we could write this is multiply by the ratio of the two streams. We know that 90% is recycled and 10% isn't. So using that ratio, we could solve for the mass flow rate M5. And when we do that, we get M5 is equal to 1,547 kilograms per hour. Now, for those of you that didn't like the ratio system, we could write it out as such. Again, 0.15 times M4, so that's our solution, that's equal to 10% of the total solution. So 10% times the total solution, which is 0.15 M4, plus now M5. So given the information we have for M4, you could plug in that value and solve for M5, and you'll get the same thing. It may also be good practice to simplify this equation to see how we got the ratio in the first place. So now the question is, do we solve for M2? Well, we don't really need it. All that's left to solve for in this problem is the molar flow rate of air entering the dryer, N1. So to get that, we have information about the water that's removed. We have a relationship between the water that comes in and the water that leaves, so we need to convert the water that comes into the dryer into a molar flow rate so that we can solve for our air. So let's first figure out how much water we have coming into the dryer. So we know that 85 weight percent of the solution is water, so 0.85 times our solution, which is 15 weight percent of M4. So that's the water that enters, which means that this is going to be the water that leaves, which we know is 0.08 times N2. Now the problem is on the left side we have a mass flow rate, on the right side we have a molar flow rate, so we need to divide the left side by the molecular weight of water, which is 18 times 10 to the minus 3 kilograms. So again, we could plug in M4, solve for N2, and I get that the molar flow rate N2 is equal to 1.01 times 10 to the 5th moles per hour. So now we have N2, we could easily solve for N1, the final part of this problem. So now for air, we know that 92 mole percent of N2 is equal to N1. Thus, N1, the molar flow rate of air that enters our system, is 9.3 times 10 to the 4th moles per hour. So now we've solved for the 3 molar flow rates we were looking for. Hopefully this gave you a good idea on how to approach a multiple unit material balance and how we could use specific information about the streams to help us solve for unknowns.